crossed over after the Connect River was the Matt Newsom River. So guess what this one is? It is also the Matt Newsom River. And on this river, you can see all the silt in the middle. The water's kind of high. Well, that's a very good chance to view how these split up rivers are made. The Matt Newsom River is fed by a glacier. And like many rivers in Alaska, the water level can vary a lot. So when the water is high, it tends to carve out a flat bank, flat bottom. When the water level starts to drop, the river will carve out separate channels. Those little islands are different. Are those silt bars that are splitting up the separate channels? You can see the extent of how much these rivers are braided or split apart by the distance between those two rivers. Is the Susitna River, one of those big braided ones that I discussed before Talkeetna. These little islands in the middle, they've been there for a while. You can tell, of course, because there's trees on it. But the water does change courses very often. And as it does so, it picks up dirt and it also drops it off. It drops off the glacial silt from the glaciers. That's why it has such a murky color. That silt is a very fine powder, enough to get suspended in the water. So this water does look dirty, and the native Alaskans, they named it after the dirt in the river. The Susit part of Susitna means sandy or silty. and at night, well, you'll find that at the end of almost all Alaskan rivers around Anchorage. That's because the Athabascans, their word for flowing water was none. So even in Talkeetna, three rivers that flow into the Susitna River at Talkeetna are the Talkeetna Rivers, the Susitna River, and the Tulitna River.
Right-hand side, this is the Eads Lake. Coming up here real soon, we're going to see two blue and yellow signs, one on the right and one on the left. It's going to say the highest point of the Alaska Railroad, and it'll say 2,263 feet in height. Now, when we get to that point, then we'll be starting to go downhill.
Right.
Hotels on the right hand side. And this signals for about about 7 miles outside of the park.
They want animals. I don't want
to stop.
Wow.
Now, just a heads up, like I said, we're about 7 miles from the depot. So if you guys could just start thinking about picking up your area. So right before we get into the park, into the depot, I should say, we're going to cross over the Riley Creek Bridge. And then we'll see the Hines Creek and the Riley Creek on the left-hand side separately, and then together on the right-hand side. Left, separate, right, together. So that's right before we pull into the depot. So that's the last thing we see as we pull into the depot.
The Atlantic salmon doesn't die. It can go back and do it again.
All five
species of the Pacific salmon do die, but the Atlantic salmon.
ここから取る?
わかんない。早くしなさい。構えない。構えてる。構えてる。皆さん、みんな構えてるのに。構えてるの。来ないんだよ。皆さん、みんな構えてるのに。構えてるの来ないんだ。
This is the last portion that we're going to be seeing at the end.
I don't record. health promotion.
They have a huge range. Their swimming pool is extremely large. Out in Cody, yeah, Kipiani, we're not guaranteed to see orcas every day. Probably 50% of our trips or less. So whenever these guys are nice enough to present themselves to us, I always like to thank them for it, especially to be in such a nice calm area as this. Back there. If you don't have a reservation, he doesn't let you in there.